Hello dear students, this is Vijay and please go to the demonstration of still life now. Here's the demonstration. I have kept the tea kettle and the glass and the cup and saucer and the biscuit packet and the strainer. Although at the end of the demonstration you will notice that I have eliminated the glass and just have kept the four simple objects in front of me. Right now what I am doing, I am just coloring the background. You might have seen the pic which was there in front of me that was having the blue background. So keeping that in mind, I took ultramarine blue, then I added a Persian blue and bit black and white to the tone. This is I am coloring right now foreground and the background. This is one very interesting trick I would like to share with you. So when you cover this aspect first, the background and the foreground, most of the area of the page is colored, and then finally you can concentrate on the core objects. This is a very good technique to reduce the burden, and this is a psychological at least, but then it does play the important role. Believe me, it really works. So the suggestion is, like, first color your foreground and background. As earlier also I mentioned that my foreground and the background especially I keep it dark, and foreground is a little bit lighter than the background. And when I color, I'm not thinking about my outlines. My coloring is overlapping the outlines. You'll find the kettle is almost disturbed. The outline is almost disturbed. See, I have removed the glasses. So as I told you, like, I'm going to concentrate on the core object. And this, I am using a flat brush right now. Flat brush is just to cover up the work very fast. You can also do the same thing. And later on I'm going to use the round brush also, the small size brush, but right now to cover up the bigger portion of the paper, I'm deliberately using a flat brush, the bigger size brush. Let's proceed the painting of the cattle, starting from the deep tone, that is a dark tone. As I mentioned in my earlier demonstration also, I have developed a style of painting from the deep tone to light tone, but does not mean that you also should follow the same way. This is up to the individual. You can develop your own style of drawing and painting. You can develop picture from the light to dark also, but this is what I have chosen, developing picture from dark to light. Now deep tone I gave initially, and now I am giving light tone. This is, I give the reflection tone. I was continuously observing towards the object. Morning it was having some other still light on its surface. Then later on, as the day was passing by, I came across with a different light. And you might have seen initially I kept a dark patch on the lid, that is a cover, and again I turned into light. Now you'll notice one part, that the tones are taking its places and shades are taking its places. So tones and shades, the shades means after adding the deep tone, color turns into shades. After adding the light tone, color turns, that is called tint. So when you add deep tone to the color, that is shade. When you add light tone to the color, that is tint. So playing with the tints and the shades and continuously observing, asking myself whether the tint which I have put, or the shade which I have put on the object, is it right? Or is it wrong? Is it appropriate? Is it less? Is it more? This kind of questions you have to keep on asking to yourself. Yes, this is a good sign of the artist, that if you talk with yourself, that when after touching the brush, just take a pause for the second moment and just ask yourself, a tone or the shade which I have applied, is it the same which what I am seeing right now in front of me, or there is some difference? And if there is a difference, it means I need to recreate the shade. I need to recreate the tint. I need to recreate the tone. Right now, I am having flat brush only in my hand. Only the size is reduced. The brush size is now small. For the background and foreground, I was having bigger size brush. Right now, I am having a small size brush. Here, going next to. And I'm focusing at the same time, I'm focusing on the folds also I have to show. Then I have to make it sure that the that the objects are kept into the blue shade area. Yes, you can see in and around of the in and around the object, the drapery color is in blue tone. So somewhere naturally blue is going to take its place. I mean blue is going to come on the object. So now you see, you can see a gray shade which I have done that has the tint of blue. Which blue? That is the ultramarine blue. So black, white and ultramarine blue shades. Please ignore this camera also, a little bit shake because of the touch. Now creating the shade once again, and light tone, deep tone, dark tone, continuously asking myself like the tone are right or tones are not right. Now why orange? You know, orange packet was kept, so orange reflection was on the surface of the jar. You'll notice one thing, that the initially the cover, the lid of the tea kettle was very much fine, and I mixed the entire background. See what I'm doing. You'll find, sir, what are you doing? I'm deliberately merging the outlines in the background, so the cutting and pasting part of the picture will go away. And right now, as I told you, like I felt like let's cover this rest of the area of the page and concentrate on the core objects, so I get a quality time in my hand to give justice to the objects. While coloring the foreground, I removed the handles of this strainer. Now I am not having these strainer handles in front of me. Mixing the tone again, and now you'll find a complete one tone picture. Complete one tone picture. Add here, adding more details. Same brush I'm having in my hand, trying to catch the symmetry. You would wonder, sir, on the same area you have applied the tint at least 3 times. Yes, this is called the experiment. You have to, there is no end to the perfection. You have to develop your observation ability. What is the meaning of still life? Still life meaning is to develop the ability of observation. Now what I am doing, I am developing the ability of my observation. And you would ask, sir, what was the first observation wrong? No, it was not wrong. The light was changing continuously. Here also same thing was happening. So for suggestion for you is, when you keep the object in front of you, make it sure the light remains, light is stable. It's not changing. That will really help you a lot. That will reduce a lot of work. Now you can see near the jar, now you can see one thing, the deep tone, the background tone, I'm deliberately merging, deliberately, I was fetching in the inside the object, because that should look like it's a part of the picture. So instead of making borders too much sharp, I'm merging them. You can see here now, see what I did, look at this, and I merged it later on, although I took the dark tone. And these experiments you have to do. Be confident when you paint, feel free when you throw the colors on the object. I can see I'm just, this is the brushing style. You can also develop your own way of brushing, no? Just adding more light, then it's not showing its result. So I was continuously trying to achieve the result. Further, I have taken round brush also. Now I'm making it sure that entire painting should look give very much smooth effect. I wish to give smooth effect to my painting, and academic touch. One thing you'd also say, sir, yes, one thing is there, that we are right now concentrating exactly on the object, and our attention is also exactly on the object and not on the neither on the background nor on the foreground. You know why? Because the background and foreground colors were so much dull. So this technique you have to remember, that the background and foreground color should not be fresh at all. You have to take help of the shades which will make your color dull, which will reduce the intensity of the color. So even if the backdrop and foreground is in blue, you will not say it's exact blue. It's a dull tone of blue. Now I took a round brush in my hand and concentrating on the highlights, you can see now pot has started shining. And very carefully I'm just giving the patches of the highlight. Middle tone, again deep tone, and again highlight. Here's the handle. Handle, like, it's actually, you know, when you make it sure that you are showing the smaller than smallest part or the keen observation when you display on your paper, naturally the painting starts looking real. You can see I'm trying to show the nuts and bolts of the tea kettle, like the handle was connected to the pot. So how it was connected, there were two bolts, I mean to say there was two screw, so this screw also I have shown, and then that the screws were creating the shadow, those things also I have shown. And you know that handle was having one wire, one ribbon on it, and that was in some yellow ochre shade, but it was not exactly yellow ochre. See what I'm doing now, just adding a little bit yellow ochre, taking help of a little bit of yellow ochre, and that is it, little bit touches, that's it, no more things. Because you show too many details, you will end up with the frustration saying, sir, time here I made out, means we did not get time. So to avoid that, make it sure that you are smart enough to take the decision where you need to move your brush faster and where you need to be more careful while painting. And again, this middle is in a poster color, so you know it is giving me liberty to make necessary changes. It is giving me liberty to overlap the paints. When you deal with the watercolor, these liberties you don't get. Because in watercolor, dear students, once the white area is overlapped with the deep shades, you will never ever be able to turn them into light tone. And here I am adding more and more details on the handle right now to bring more original and real look of the object. So you can see, being an art teacher, for me also it's a struggle time to get the exact feel. See, I'm trying to fetch the background color inside the object and later on giving the reflection tone. So that makes my picture more 3D, more real, more realistic. And end result is really awesome. At the end, you'll find the picture when it is completed, it looks just like the pure piece of fine art. And I'm sure you will also be able to achieve such result, provided you follow these steps. I have tried showing my palette a little bit, so bit idea also you will get, like the way of mixing the shades, the way of creating the tones and tints. Now I have chosen more smaller brush and adding. Now you can see the bolt, the screw which I spoke to you about, that I have shown the highlight on that, and adding these details now. Can see deep tone there. Yeah, this is it now. More highlight, and here you can see below the nozzle, there's a deep tone. And highlight. Now you can see more रियलिस्टिक लुक। मर्ज इट, डू नॉट कीप इट हार्ड, नेवर एवर ट्राई टू पेंट एनीथिंग विच इज हार्ड, विच लुक्स हार्ड, विच इट विल ऑटोमेटिकली इंडिकेट यू, योर आईज विल से इट्स पियर्सिंग माई आईज। You can see, what I'm doing. I have faced an entire deep tone, and now see how gradually light I will increase. You can see, this is the way you should apply the reflection tone. This is the technique. This makes your work more real, and picture also looks as a part of one masterpiece. And gradually you can put a deep tones later on. Trying to achieve more details and more perfection. Keep changing, keep making the shades, keep washing your brush, keep cleaning your brush, it's very much important. Now, this what I'm doing right now, you will find it's a shadow of the tea kettle. More deep tone, and more deep tone. Yes, here also more deep tone. You will find it's just like a shadow. I took a flat brush to merge it. So after dealing with the round brush, I took a flat brush also. So sometime you have to use this technique. And you can see here more deep. That part was in shadow. So more deep tone I have added by taking the black and blue and white. White and black for the making gray and blue just to reflect. It's a bluish gray. Because you cannot make picture only with a black and white, it will look monochromatic. So to remove the monochromatic effect, because one thing you will notice in this still life, that all objects are into the combination of gray. For example, cup and saucer, gray combination. Tea kettle, gray combination. Strainer, gray combination. Only biscuit packet is in orange, and that is only going to make a viewer understand that this is not a monochromatic painting, this is a colorful painting. And you can see another part also, apart from black and blue, I am taking help of yellow ochre also. For example, handle, the ribbon which was wrapped to the handle was in yellow ochre tone. So that yellow ochre tone, which you are eyewitnessing right now, is mixed with black and white. So the gray which I am having right now on my entire still life, is the yellowish gray, and another one is a bluish gray. Right now what I'm doing is showing more detailing on the handle. So wire which was wrapped. Typically you will observe this when you will go to a tea shop, roadside tea shop I mean to say, that is called Chai Tapri. So when you go to this shop, you will notice, you will observe this. Actually, I understand this tea kettle you might not be having at your home, you might be having a teapot. And even if you don't have teapot, you can simply keep a steel jar. You can simply keep steel jar. So, because this object, though it was out of interest, I went in market and bought this object and painted. Actually, one more thought I would now see what I'm doing. I'm showing the more detailing on the handle, and now you'll find one thing: the handle is really showing its impact. The heaviness of the object, you'll find that handle is heavy. That heaviness has come in a picture. So, this when you add these details, it does make a difference. You would wonder, sir, why to show this all small, small details? You are showing screw, you are showing where the screw has started, you are showing the reflection and shadow on the screw also. So many detailing. But if you add these details, then only your picture will look real. These small, small things are going to add value in your picture. You can see more deep tone I have added. Oh my God, it's too much dark. This is what will come in your mind. But see, later on I have merged it in such a way that it will not be a hard on the picture, plus it will create a good tonal value also. Now you'll find a good contrast, good light, and the size of the brush which I'm using right now, there's a number 2, number 3, number 4. These are the brushes size with which I am dealing right now. So initially you might have seen I used the flat brush to cover the entire picture, and later on I used the round brush to show the details. Again, I am adding more details on the lid of the tea kettle. You can see here the small details are creating more and more interest in my picture. So, when it comes to you, dear students, please observe and observe and observe the same repetition of this word three times was in my previous demonstration as well. And know what I'm doing right now? I'm coloring the biscuit packet. You would ask, the biscuit packet was in orange color, why have it in the grayish orange? Yes, I have to do the grayish orange because that part is in the shadow, and when orange goes in the shadow, that orange is not orange, it's a part of gray tone. It's a part of gray tone. And you'll notice I applied yellow because yellow is such a shade. Yellow cannot be overlapped on any other shades. Yellow cannot be overlapped on any other shade. That is the reason initially, if you want to use yellow, initially only you paint it and later on you give other colors, because other colors can easily get overlapped on lemon yellow or chrome yellow or cadmium yellow. But if you say that initially I have some deep tone on that color you want to paint yellow, then it goes very difficult. Perhaps in poster it might be available after some struggle, but in water, forget it. Never ever you will be able to get your yellow again if yellow it takes place initially. And this all things you are going to learn after practice and practice and practice. I'm trying to achieve more and more details now. There were lot many folds on the biscuit packet, so these folds I'm trying to show. Initially you might have seen what was the journey, how the journey was of orange color biscuit packet, and now and how it's looking right now. So there's a change, and again more deep tone. And yes, now what I'm doing right now with smaller size brush, almost number 2 or number 3 I was having in my hand, and I'm trying to show that biscuit package was of some company, but yes, the product was, that flavor was orange, and on the biscuit package there was one whole orange and the sliced orange, and there were the wheat seeds, wheat plant, along with two biscuits, and then a lot of information like brand, then the weightage, then the vegetarian symbol, that is a green in a circle, green in a round, and square is around. You can see here I'm trying to show the surface of the biscuit. I want to say this is all what I'm doing, the designing part which was on a biscuit packet cover, that I'm trying to show. Actually from the distance hardly the things are seen, so but the best of the ability I'm trying to display, that even if the one seeds I was trying to show. So sitting at one place, I know the still life escaped in front of you, so it does not mean that you will ignore this observation. By doing this you are going to develop the ability of observation only. So whatever I am able to see from my angle, like biscuit packet designing, I was able to see, I was able to read the brand, I was able to read the stickers, the information which was written on the brand, written on the cover was also a little bit seen, although I was not able to read it. But from the distance one thing was clear, that something is written on it. So that now you can see what I'm doing. I'm putting the gray tone. You'd ask why this? That reflection of the tea kettle is falling on the orange packet. So reflection is what I'm trying to show. And same thing, the orange color packet was reflecting its shadow on the tea kettle. So wherever the shadow is passing by, you'll find that I have added orange in that. And you can see I'm struggling continuously to show those minute details on the biscuit packet. So keep on observing. Now you can see that biscuit packet which I had painted initially, again I'm painting that, because with the previous result I was not satisfied, so I painted it again. And go on showing more and more and more and more details. When you are dealing with the light tone, do not take black unnecessarily. Now I'm slightly going down, the highlight part is done. I'm going to the middle tone. Now one can easily make out, yes, it's a biscuit packet, although the detailing has not yet come. At the end, when at a glance, when you will see the picture, you will find, yeah, exactly, the biscuit packet is reflecting its brand, the surface, the cover is shiny. Sometimes the biscuit packet covers are in a paper, sometimes the biscuit packet covers are in a बॉक्स बोर्ड पेपर, समटाइम द बिस्किट पैकेट कवर्स आर इन अ प्लास्टिक. सो दिस डिफ्रेंसिएशन यू मस्ट बी एबल टू शो. नाउ यू कैन सी माई एंटायर डिटेलिंग ऑन द बिस्किट पैकेट इज डन. यू कैन सी ऑरेंजेस, द स्लाइस ऑरेंज, द वेजिटेबल सिम्बॉल. एंड राइट नाउ व्हाट आई एम डूइंग, गेस आउट, गेस दिस. This is a strainer. Yes, dear students. Now, after completing the tea kettle, biscuit packet, the next attempt which I am doing right now, that is a strainer. Handle I had colored initially. I mean to say, I just overlapped foreground on the handle because if I would have left that, then again things would have been difficult to cover in time. So, keeping that in mind, I just overlapped my color on the outline. And right now see what I'm doing. These are the strokes. Keep the confidence in your stroke, keep the line straight, and I complete the handle. Yeah, this is the technique. Use the round brush, then again the flat brush, again use the round brush, again use the flat brush. So wherever the round brush is creating hardness, with the help of flat brush remove that hardness. And the net of the strainer was so close that I was not able to see through. That actually you say that you may ask, sir, that why the cloth is not seen from the strainer. No, I was not able to see. It was a steel strainer and the net was so close by that it was not allowing me to see through. It's light now. The strainer also, wherever it was having up and down effect. I am trying to show the up and down effects also on the strainer. And this was a deep area and I am showing the shadow. Here is the shadow now, and gradually the deep tone when the shadow is close to the object. So keeping that sense in mind, when the shadow is close to the object, please keep it deep and dark. As the shadow is going away from the object, you can turn it into light. Just adding more light, and here adding more deep tone and trying to bring the handle in the discipline. Right now handle is not in discipline. You see there are a lot many lines, the thickness is too big, but gradually now I am going to achieve that result. And see what I am doing now, I am cutting the edges, I am cutting, you see more cut, I am cutting the edges. And now you can see, this was a deep tone, entire inside part was in deep tone because biscuit packet was creating its shadow, strainer was creating its shadow. The pot itself was creating its shadow, not an entire big shadow, but at least the deep tone. It was not allowing light to go on that area. So naturally what I did, I put the deep tone there. I just took the very close angle now, just to make you understand that how I am coloring the strainer and what detailing I am doing. So well, this is done. Minute effects. More deep tones, and again more deep tones, going close to the object, yeah, more deep tone, yes, here they are now, and here I am now with more detailing. So this is how picture looks like. Please ignore that white spot, that color fall on paper. Now cup and saucer. Before, actually what I did, I just made it bit short and sweet. So I just colored initially light part, middle tone, dark tone, these three colors I applied to the cup and saucer. And now I'm just showing you the additional detailing, how to make it more perfect and fine. So initial part of the cup and saucer painting I just ignored and removed it because that was just similar to the tea kettle, the same treatment I had given here also. Observation and only observation. So as this is a mantra actually, you know, observation is a mantra. Keep observing, keep adding the details. And again here the detailing, the shadow of the cup which is falling on the saucer. And very small size brush, 2-3 number size brushes that I'm holding in my hand, and the handle of cup. Again on this handle also, all three lights are falling, light tone, middle tone, dark tone. filled up this batch. Created the shadow again of copper, but later on I'm going to merge it. See, right now only, because although cup and saucer is white, you would ask me this question, sir, you have shown that the saucer below part in blue, why? Because cup and saucer was having the character of the cup and saucer is water, so it catches the reflection, it's shiny, it has a shiny surface. You can see the hardness of the shadow, so I removed, because initially it was very hard. I am merging the edges in the background to keep it soft, and shadows also, I don't want very hard shadow, so remove the hardness and spreading the light eventually to create the good impact of the light all over the picture, that even if one happens to have a look at a glance, he should be or she should be able to make out that from which direction the light is falling on the object. That is it, and now more deep tone, more light tone, more light tone, and yes, here it's done. Reflection in the shadow also, there was a reflection, so I added this. Otherwise, you say, sir, there was also, now you can see it's more smooth, and on this part when the light was actually main, the intensity of light here, it was more. So it's the same thing. More rendering, more observation, just showing light wherever the light is actually falling. Same brush I'm holding in my hand, it's a small size brush. Nowhere I have touched flat brush later on, only background, foreground and big object. Strainer, biscuit packet, yes, I was holding flat brush in my hand, but when it comes to you, not compulsory. Avoid. See what I have done now, you will ask me, sir, what are you doing, you are spoiling entire picture. No, I am merging this entire edges because the picture was very heavy, that heaviness I am trying to remove now. Now see what I will do, see what I have done. I'm trying to merge these outlines, dear students. If you use this technique in your picture, see what I did. You say, oh my god, entire painting is spoiled. No, I'm not spoiling the painting. I'm trying to make my edges more sharp and smooth. More smooth. Instead of sharp, more smooth I'm trying to make. So that will, you know, do the good. See, here also I'm doing the same thing. See what I've done. You say, sir, you have removed the entire outline you have broken. This technique now, it depends, you know, after a lot of practice you learn one thing, that you can keep the outline in control. Even if the outline is, you see, here also I did the same thing. You say, sir, here also you have broken everything. But when, if I don't do this, the painting will look very hard. See what I've done. Same thing. Everywhere merging. See, here also merging. You say, sir, here also you have merged. Here is the background tone entirely, it has entered on the main object, and now slightly giving the dark touches. So one thing will be clear, that from where the lid starts, where is the edge of the object, that part is clearly seen in my boy. You can see here one thing. You say, sir, oh my god, you have damaged the entire biscuit packet. No, I am removing the hardness. Here also shadow was creating, it's too much hard effect. So take a flat brush in your hand, you can also use this technique to make the outline more soft, and this comes with the regular practice. This is not like all of a sudden. If you have practiced my earlier demonstration, then definitely you will be able to achieve this result. But if you have not practiced that, then don't do this experiment, it will spoil your picture in real sense. Now I took a small brush in my hand and I am trying to repair the area which were like too much where the edge was not very much clear. Rather, I removed the palette aside now, just have taken one middle tone in my brush and trying to bring one smooth effect on it, smoothness. I am trying to bring the smoothness on it. Here I took a more deep tone because somewhere I wanted to show folds. Folds, you cannot ignore the folds here, students. You can see here one fold is inside also, and restore folds you just might have seen just now. And I have seen many students struggling on the folds. You don't have to struggle on the folds. Use the technique. Use a flat brush. Just drag it, but be confident when you drag the folds. You might have seen in no time I created 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 folds. Once the picture is dried, you will find the wonderful effects of the folds. Done. That is it. See, now you can see here. This is what I'm telling you, the shadow part, sorry, the fold part. And here also, I'm trying to bring more discipline in the picture later on. First, what I did, I merged the outline, and later on, slightly discipline I brought. And here, this is how your output will look like. Although, photo, I guess, the angle was something different. So, that angle did not come properly, so I have added one more snap. Have a look at this. This is the actual view of the picture. This is how the picture will look like. Thank you so much.